Well, there are fans from all over the country here at Westminster, and all of the major London clubs are represented. At least 1,000 fans have turned up here for the lobby, which could go on for several hours. They've also brought a massive petition from Liverpool. This is 50,000 signatures complaining about the Sun's coverage of the Hillsborough disaster, and this is going to Downing Street later. First of all, though, can you make them change their minds?
Well, let's hope so. I really think that the Tories have underestimated the feeling that there is against this. Virtually everyone in football, whether it's the fans, whether it's football authorities, whether it's the players, even the police, completely against the ID card scheme. They think there's no, you know, it's irrelevant to the question of football hooliganism, the ID cards.
So it looks now as if the campaign is set to continue.
Hear about is rivalry against football fans, but here all the fans united for a decent purpose. Over there at Westminster in Parliament, you've got people voting on the future of football, when to be honest, half of them have never been to a football match in their life. Most of them are more at home at the Henley Regatta eating smoked salmon than being down at Upton Park in the pouring rain in February when you're losing. That's the fans are the people who really know what's all about in football. They're the people who should be asked about facilities, about the ID cards, and the reason they're not being asked about the ID cards is because if they were, there'd be one answer: no thanks, we don't really want it.
But can you impress your view on them? Can you make them change their minds?
Well, let's hope so. I really think that the Tories have underestimated the feeling that there is against this. Virtually everyone in football, whether it's the fans, whether it's football authorities, whether it's the players, even the police, completely against the ID.